Hello, and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner. Once a week, I pick some topic of interest in C++ and dig into it with some live coding. In this episode, I'm going to give an overview of the standard bind function and its capabilities. So if you look at the documentation for standard bind, it seems a bit obtuse, maybe simplistic. So it takes a thing called f, that is a callable, which means a function object, pointer to function, reference to pointer, reference to function, pointer to member function, pointer to data member. It's anything that can be called as if it were a function. And then it takes a list of arguments that want to be bound to this function call. So in the most simplistic sense, it binds parameters to functions. Let's say, for instance, that we have this function called print, and it takes an integer, and we're going to do it by const reference to make a point later, and we simply want to print out this value. So we can create a new callable thing, and that's what bind does, is it takes a callable object and returns a new callable one. And if you noticed in the documentation, it says the return value is unspecified. It's basically unknowable and implementation defined. So we need to use auto to capture one of these. And we can do something like bind print 5. And now we should get, every time we call f, the value 5 print to the screen. And sure enough. And we can also do something like I equals 5 here, and bind the value I thusly, and we get the same result. Now, the point that I started to make earlier is if we reassign I the value 6 and rerun this, we still only get 5 printed out. And that's because one of the things that bind guarantees it will do is make a copy of the arguments passed in. So if we wanted the value to actually track, we would need to make a standard reference wrapper object for it. Now when we execute, we get 5 and 6, which is what we would expect based on what we're doing here, and based on the fact that this takes a reference. Now, it's also interesting to note just how long this takes to compile. That's 0.6 seconds and 58 megs of RAM for a quite trivial test case. So bind is not a very lightweight thing, and it is definitely something that should be used judiciously. So what else can bind do? If we wanted, for example, this to take multiple arguments, then let's take this back to not being a reference because that's a little silly. But let's say we do want it to also print a string. We might do something like this. And now what we can do is say, well, we want the first value to be bound to this variable I, but we want the second one to be specified by the user. So now, f is a callable thing that takes one parameter, and we could do something like hello world, and we get hello world. And notice that our 5 and 6 is still tracking, and that's because it is actually the thing returned by standard bind that is owning the standard reference object. Oops. So we didn't need the parameter to take a reference because and bind internally is going to handle the reference as we would expect it to. So looking further, bind lets you do crazy things like reorder parameters. So we can say pass the second parameter as if it were the first parameter, and the first parameter as if it were the second. So now we've just swapped our function around, and instead of taking an integer followed by a string, it takes a string followed by an integer. And everything still works like we expected it to. So there's all kinds of interesting things we could do here. We can also, since bind actually is designed to swallow all of the extra arguments passed to it. So we can do something like this, and it still compiles, and we still get the same output. And to me, I definitely wonder if this is a fallout of the fact that bind was implemented before variadic templates and before C++11 and before auto and all of these niceties. And then it makes me wonder if this is actually just because it was easier to design it so that it swallows all the extra arguments up to however many it is it can take. And it says it's unspecified, I believe, but I'm kind of curious now if you would get an error after it swallows too many. It doesn't seem to care. So anyhow, so now the next thing you need to know about bind is that because it expects a concrete function argument here, if this was a template, and we say we want this first thing being passed in to be of type T, and now we try to compile, we're going to get an error here because of an unresolved overloaded function type being passed as the first parameter to bind. And that's because you cannot simply take a pointer to a template function. There's no way to do this. It has to be a concrete thing. So we can specify int, and now it works as we expected again, and we get the expected results. It's also worth noting that since bind returns a callable thing, it can be passed into standard function. So if we wanted to make something that could be passed around with a known type, then we might want to do something like void int and we can initialize it with the bind result. At least we should have been able to. Cannot convert basic string to int. Oh, that's because we swapped the order of the parameters in our example up there. So bind can be used to make all kinds of nifty little adapter things. There we go. And indeed, before auto existed, you know, with some caveats, passing the result of a bind to a standard function was pretty much the only reasonable thing that you could do with it. Now, granted, standard bind didn't come into existence until C++11, and C++11 also introduced the auto keyword, but bind was originally part of boost. And that's if you were using it back in those days, then you really couldn't store it in any reasonable way. You kind of had to pass it around and put it into some type erasing wrapper, which is what standard function gives us. And then with standard function, we can continue our hello world kind of test here and get the results that we expect still. But it's now much more strongly typed than our bind was because standard function requires all your parameter types to match. So I guess that wraps it up. A couple of things to keep in mind. Print, excuse me. Bind requires a function pointer or some sort of other callable thing, so you can't pass a template to it. That's just a generic template. You can reorder arguments. Keep in mind that it copies the arguments that you pass in. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and be sure to leave a comment or share the video with someone else. Be sure to subscribe, follow me on Twitter, and check out any of the links below.